Hello there. It's Friday. We're going into the weekend, and I wanted to give you maybe a small reminder, or maybe ask you just like tell you something that can maybe make you ask yourself certain questions so you kind of move your life in a little bit different direction. And I want to talk today about this: am I enough? Am I really enough to do whatever I want to do? You know, today it's a big thing, and I have teenage girls, and it's all about you are enough. You know, nobody's supposed to tell you that you are not. But then on the other side, you have that really thing that your personality is creating your personal reality. And if you are not getting in life things that they are like that you don't like, you kind of have to change some things. So I really want to talk today a little bit and you know, about that thing. Are you enough? And what does it mean you have to become someone else? And I'm going to just start with the story about myself, how when I started my personal development program, and when I started the coaching with the Bob Proctor organization, and they were all talking about this. And trust me, for some point of time, I almost went to like kind of dark moments saying, how come I'm not enough? I thought that I can do everything, that I can do the different things. And now it looks like that I cannot. And it took me a little bit of like coaching and time to understand and to become aware that being not good enough doesn't mean that I have to become my teacher, my mentor, my neighbor, like anyone else. And I learned that if I want to be free, I got to be me. And I better know who me is. So this is where I start searching for who is that me? I thought I can do it, but I cannot. You know who is that me? That me is the person who fell asleep all this way when the life was happening. You know, the person who forgot to imagine, to let like your imagination drives you really wild and go different places and really bring you different results and different things in life. Not being good enough, it doesn't mean you have to be somebody else. You just have to mean that you have to become more aware of what's going on right now, of every present moment. That you have to start paying attention to the life that's happening right now and stop living in the past and in the future. Stop living in the trauma of if your husband cheated on you, if he left you, if you get in a fight with your best friend and you're not best friends anymore, if you lost a job, if anything happened. Trust me, every single person who did something with their life that they're happy and satisfied, they're the people that they are able to create the circumstances, and not the one that they live according to the circumstances. If you let your life like move you around, you become a victim of your husband, of your past, and your body, trust me, remembers that emotions that you went through. And right now you have different situation happening. You know what your body says? No, 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 no. That's unfamiliar. You're not going there. You are going to live this again. You're not going to better because you cannot. You're not good enough. It's too late. You're never going to succeed. Nobody in your family succeeded. These are the things that you're going to hear. And that's going to all happen until the day that you're going to sit, that you're going to stand up and say, no, this time I'm taking charge. I'm not a victim of my past. I'm not living in the fear of my future. It's a skill that you have to build to become aware of the present moment, to listen when people talk to you, to listen, to see what's going on around you, to take the sip of water and be aware of that sip of water. This is what's important. Once you're going to start building that skill, you're going to be paying attention. How do I feel at the moment? What I'm thinking right now about my past, does this create a different future, different moment right now? No. I'm not going to think about that. I'm going to leave that there and I'm going to make a peace with that. And then you're going to look in your future and you're going to create a habit that fate become a habit of looking in the future with the only thoughts that you want to happen. This is also a habit. So not being good enough is that person who you became by being a victim of life, by being programmed with social media, with people telling you that you cannot or that you are not able, with yourself accepting their programs and start repeating that to yourself on a daily basis. Oh, I cannot do that. Oh my God, they were right. I'm never going to do it. Wake that person inside of you. You know, in your life, we always go with like, what do I want? How do I get that? And what steps, what's on the way? It's always easy to say, what do I want? But then right away, your subconscious jump, your memories from the past jump. So trust me, if you want to create different reality, if you want to create different life for yourself, for your family, you're going to have to change your personality. And you know what? The moment that you have to do that, your body's gonna, it's not gonna agree. And your mind, your conscious mind and your subconscious, they're gonna say, no, no, I'm not ready for that. But you have to be ready. The moment you decide, the thing's gonna change. So what's on the way? What's on the way to get where you wanna get? Can you teach your body emotionally in the present moment the beauty of thing that you want that it didn't happen yet? Once you're going to be able to reach that, trust me, everything will change. When you will be able to create emotion of the life that you want to live in the future, right now, while you're sitting in your house, in your car, on the street, and in the park, and you hate your life maybe, and you don't think you're good enough, when you're going to be able to create the feeling of happiness inside for the things that they're about to come, everything's going to change. So what do you want in life? How do you get that? And what's on the way? I still have a couple of places. Actually, no, for this week, we are full. We finished the week. We finished, but I still have a couple of places for the next week. We have a couple of 30 minutes coaching sessions. Please don't be shy. Send me a message. Let me know. We can always set up a 30-minute call and we can go over the things that you think keeps you stuck. And trust me, you are enough, but that you who is sleeping inside, not you who you became by being programmed with everything that's happening around. So until next week, enjoy your weekend, love yourself, look inside and see who you really are. Remember, look in your heart, the answer is always there. Have a great weekend, everybody. Bye now.